Hi beloved, for this video I want to talk about, ooh, my voice sounds so deep today, but anyway, for this video I want to talk about empaths and I guess protecting your energy. So a lot of people that are empaths or consider themselves empaths really struggle with I guess protecting their energy. They find themselves feeling tired because they keep absorbing everybody's stuff. So whether this is through people sharing their story or through the people that they're trying to help or through this certain space of healing that they're in, I just want to tell you that if you're an empath, you really don't always have to carry other people's stuff. And a big part, before I go into steps that are going to help you in order to I guess ground and manage your energy better and also protect your energy, it's really just boundaries, boundaries, boundaries. Most empaths do not have boundaries at all. So if you are an empath, it's quite important that you know when to set your boundaries. People do not necessarily have to always have access to you. And I know as empaths, they tell themselves the story that I have to help people, I have to do this. And really sometimes it's your ego taking you into spaces that you don't necessarily really need to go into because you're avoiding healing something that is actually within yourself that you're projecting onto the person that you're trying to help. I don't know if that makes sense, but really, if you're an empath, you probably understood that. And it's just to say that it's okay to set boundaries. You don't need to save everybody that comes into your path. And I think it's also an ego thing to try and save everybody else. And sometimes the people that come into your life are there to help you. Set boundaries, but because you keep avoiding that and you're like, oh, I need to help this person has this problem, you don't see the lessons that you're supposed to be learning from that experience, such as that you need to set boundaries, such as that you need to stop making other people's problems your own, such as that it's okay to actually choose yourself in certain situations. A lot of empaths are people that have been through certain experiences and they find themselves really sensitive to people's energies, people's thoughts, people's emotions, and they keep absorbing that. So in order to release yourself from that, you need to just learn to set boundaries and realize when it's your ego and when it's actually somebody that needs help. And if they do, they need to actually come and acknowledge that, you know what, I need help, can you assist me in this? And just let go of the idea that you have to save everybody that comes into your path. Sometimes you're really just projecting, and the moment you realize that, you free yourself from a lot of stuff. So boundaries, boundaries, boundaries are really important for empaths. You don't need to walk around absorbing everybody's energy. And even if you're not an empath, I mean, as human beings, we are energetical beings, right? So I know a lot of times when people say I'm an empath, it means I'm sensitive to people's thoughts, emotions, energy, and I absorb that. You could also just be in a healing space. You could be spiritually gifted, all that stuff, right? But at the end of the day, we're all energetical beings. And that's why it's so draining when you don't have boundaries. So whether you're an empath or not, or you're just a person who has certain beliefs, it doesn't matter what you believe, really. It's just the fact that we are all energetical beings, and every time you surround yourself with different people, you need to protect your energy. So whether you are working in a space where you're of servitude to other people, that's when you're more at risk of not setting boundaries with other people around you, because you positioned yourself in a way that you need to help, but you can't really help the other people if you are depleted yourself. So it's quite important to actually look within yourself and say, okay, is how I'm actually coexisting with other people, the same people that I say I'm helping, really helping them? How do you help people if you're exhausted, if you're heavy, right? So this is when you start to build resentment, you start to get really tired, you start to hate the work that you're actually doing, and that kind of pours out and shows in the work that you're doing, especially if you're in the healing space and helping other people's space. So for this video, whether you're an empath or not, we're all energy, and you need to guard and protect your energy, because if you don't, you will find yourself depleted and exhausted. So first, ask yourself the questions that, am I really just projecting? Do I keep taking people's stuff even when I shouldn't? And what is showing up from my own? What lesson do I also need to learn from this experience? Because it's easy to just say, oh, people just keep following me around, people always want my help. Sometimes it's ego that wants to feel important, and therefore we consistently just make it seem as though, you know, people are always following me around, etc., etc. And if you're in the healing space, it's just as important to protect your energy, it's just as important to guard your energy, it's just as important to keep your energy sacred and pure, and get enough rest and do all those beautiful things that help you to actually help the other people. So that's pretty much it. I hope this video was helpful. If you're an empath, also let me know if you have any other questions so that I can answer them in terms of how do you actually protect your energy. This video turned out a lot longer than I thought. I just filmed it at the office because I had the thought and I thought somebody might need this. So set boundaries, guys. Set boundaries. Even if you're in the helping space, set boundaries, because in order to help others, you need to help yourself. You can't give peace, you can't give healing, you can't give anything to others if you have not given it to yourself first. So that's it from me today, sending you off with love, and I hope that wherever you are, you protect your peace and protect your energy, because nobody is going to do it for you, right?